In a 1998 paper, Josh Angrist asked, if I volunteer and enlist in the military, am I going to make more money over my lifetime than if I don't join the military? So what he did is he gathered data on all applicants to the military in the years 1979 through 1982. So our population of units here is the set of all people who applied to the military. If you didn't apply, you're not in his data set. So when we talk about treatment effects later on, we're going to actually only define treatment effects for people who applied. Okay, so let's look at the data. He's got, for each applicant, the year that they applied and how much money they made in every year of their life. So let's look at just one group of applicants, 1982, people who applied to be in the military in 1982. Here, we see that in 1974, they earned $0. Well, that's probably because they were kids in 1974. In 1976, they also earned $0. In 1978, they started to earn a little bit more money. Okay, and in 1980, 1982, their earnings, which is measured on this axis, started to increase. Now he's got the group of people in 1982 split into two subgroups, people who joined the military and people who didn't. If you joined the military, your earnings are plotted on this solid line. So we see that in 1982, you made about $3,000, and then that increased to about $9,000 in 1984, and then kept increasing throughout your life. If you didn't join the military, then your earnings are shown on the dotted line. Okay, so your earnings still increased over your lifetime, but they weren't quite as high as the people who joined the military. So we see that in the data, the people who joined the military who applied in 1982 made more money over their entire life than people who didn't. Now in these other three lines, he's got the same exact data, but for people who applied in 1981, who applied in 1980, and who applied in 1979. And this graph's a little confusing when you first look at it because it's really four different graphs, one for each set of people. But in order to make it more readable, and so these lines don't overlap, he just shifted each one of these up by $3,000. So for 1981, you should think this is zero right here. And then there's an imaginary line going right here. And then likewise for 1980, there's zero is here, and there's a line on the horizontal axis here. 1979, there's a line here. So the main takeaway is that we can see for each cohort of applicants, the people who enlisted in the military made more money than the people who did not enlist in the military. Okay, there's this gap that we see in earnings over the lifetime. So the big question is that a causal effect of joining the military? Is the military doing something to people which is making them earn more money during and after they're in the military? Well, we can't learn that from just this data because all we're doing is making a raw comparison of the income of these two groups. So, and we already know from earlier models about the selection problem. There might be something that's different about the people who actually enlist in the military than the people who don't enlist in the military. And whatever that is, that could explain this difference in income, not the fact that they joined the military. So in order to disentangle that, we're going to have to do something else. And we'll see how Angrist does that in the next module.